7:14, and my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Almighty Creator God, help us to know we are in your world. Jesus, remind us you are Lord. Lord, we need baptized with the fire and the Holy Ghost. Thank you for America, Lord. One nation under God, regardless how the votes go in the world. 1621, out of the first 102 pilgrims, 32 of whom were children, only 51 survived. Only 4 of them married women. There was a price. The Blue Laws, the Puritan church members in the Massachusetts Bay Colony and later, Congregationalists elsewhere in New England, believed that their contractual relationship with God required them to enforce proper behavior in their communities. The first Blue Law, enacted in colonial Virginia in 1610, mandated church attendance at both morning and afternoon services on Sundays. A first-time offender lost his provision and allowance for the whole week. Thank you for our foundation. The pilgrims believe children should be taught the skills they would need to survive as an adult. In Plymouth Colony, this meant that a large part of a child's day was filled with work. Children as young as 5 could run errands, fetch wood or water, or even care for the chickens and animals. As children got older, their work became more and more important to the family. They became responsible. Older boys helped their fathers prepare the fields for planting, sow seeds, weed the fields, and in the late summer harvest the crops. Boys also learned to tend livestock, hunt, fish, and do any woodworking that the family needed. They were also trained to be the head of their household. As they got older and married, they would need those skills in order to be able to do the work that had to be done. Older girls worked closely with their mothers. They learned all the skills necessary to run a household. Their skills included gardening, cooking, preserving food, tending to the younger children, sewing and mending clothes and bedding. Children in Plymouth Colony did not go to school because the colony did not have a formal school. Many parents, however, taught their children to read and write at home. These lessons usually occurred in the evenings or in the winter when the farm work was finished. The Bible was the most common book in Plymouth Colony, so most children learned to read biblical passages. Horn books were made for important concepts and or Bible passages to be memorized. Thank you for our foundation. Thank you for our foundation. We came to this new land to worship you in spirit and truth. We hold the whole holding back life's truth and rule. Thank you for our foundation. Help us not to forget we had a beginning on the northeast side of our land. Help us remember you helped us go through the Louisiana Purchase, the Spanish conflict, to get to the Oregon Territory. You added states, territories. You were with us through these things. Thank you for our foundation. July 4th, 1776, the Declaration of the 13 United States of America. Now America fights a new kind of war, a war from within, unseen enemies, but one of those enemies is Satan himself. John 10:10 tells us the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and they might have it more abundantly. And Daniel in 7:25 warns us of one that will come, and he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until time and times and the dividing of time. 2 Timothy 2:19 says, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, depart from iniquity. 2 Peter 1:10 says, wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fall. 2 Peter 1:11 says, for so an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let you and I live blessed and pray always for God to bless America. Our country, may she always be right. But our country, right or wrong,
together we echo to heaven. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. ask you to stand. You'll do the pledge of life. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. announcements. Don't want to forget our outreach ministry fundraiser and no bake sale. And use those profits to build a equipment list and buy equipment for live streaming. Next Sunday on the 12th will be our board meeting after the morning service, and then that evening we'll have an annual business meeting. On July 17th and 18th we'll have a yard sale, events to support church extension. Also on the 17th, the church South Central District Council meeting, and Nitchin Camp starts that weekend on the 17th and 18th. So make sure you have time this year to go to Nitchin Camp if you so desire. Also, on July 24th at 6 p.m. at Jim and Sue McCann's house, ice cream social. So we'll join together and have a good time and just in fellowship in the Lord with that. That, my wife, you stand. We'll just sing these hymns together.
Yeah.